Hello and welcome to Red Stabler. Today we will talk about Jira REST API with cookie-based authentication. And here is Atlassian Developer Tutorials, which is detailed and I think I should simplify it a bit. The first step we are going to talk about is to create a new session using Jira REST API, which actually you just need to make a post request to this URL with a username and password credential in JSON format. And if it's success, if the credential you provided is correct, you will get a JSON response in this format, which is very important. The JSON ID you got, you will be using it as a cookie header in a subsequent request. So here's the step two, is to use the session cookie in a request. Basically, you just need to set the cookie header of all subsequent requests with the JSession IDs you just got, and that's it, you are authenticated. Let's see it in action. Here I made a simple form with a username and password and two buttons. The first button is to log in with the cookie authentication, and the second is to retrieve the user profile, which we intend to use it after we have authenticated. Both buttons will make a post request to each PHP file. The login buttons will post to jira-cookie.php and the retrieve user profile will post to jira-profile.php. Let's see the Jira cookie first. First, we're going to initialize the curl request with the REST API URL. And then we are going to get the username and password we just post to this page, and then encode it in JSON format. And then we set the curl post field with the username and password JSON. And then we set the post to true, since we are making post request, not get. We set the return transfer to true, since we want the respond, the full respond, not just the return code. And the most vital part, the HTTP headers, we need to set the content type to application JSON. And then we make the actual request, we execute the curl, and once it's completed, we will decode the JSON response. And here is the error checking steps. If there's an error, if the credential is not correct, you will get an error message back, and we will return it. But if the credential is correct, we will just set the cookies with the name and value returned from the session JSON. So that's it, that's our authentication page. The next is Jira profile, which basically quite the same. We just need to initialize the curl request to retrieve user info, set the returns transfer and the HTTP headers to application JSON. And here is the key. You need to check if there's a cookies, I mean JSON IDs cookie available. If there is, we just build a cookie string with the JSON session IDs. But if not, I will just use the blank string. And then we set the cookie headers with the cookies string we just built. And then we execute the curl. Then we decode the result and check the errors. If it's success, we return the display name and email address. But if not, return the error message. Now let's see it in action. I'm going to try hit the retrieve user profile without logging in first. You see, you are greeting with the error message. You are not authenticated. Authentication required to perform this operation, which is the error message returned from the Jira server. Now let's see if I hit the login buttons without putting anything on the form. See, login failed. Now let's try logging in. Okay, login success. And then retrieve the user profile. That's it, I've got username and email address displayed on screen. Since we are using cookie authentication, I don't need to do the login anymore. I can just retrieve whatever I want. So that's it. Thanks for watching as always. If you have any comment, any feedback, any questions, just let me know in the comment section. And don't forget to like or subscribe. Bye.